And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to another Let's Play. Today we are going to play a very special game for a very special occasion. Happy birthday, Christian. This is all your fault. Today we are going to play Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, which is generally being regarded as one of the worst and hardest, if not the worst and hardest, NES games. That's what we're going to play today, which is, since it's October, is also quite fitting thematically. So we get a little introductory cutscene showing Dr. Jekyll leaving his laboratory. But no further explanation as to what you're supposed to do or, why you're supposed to do that. So the basic story, if you can, if you can call it that, you're Dr. Jekyll and you're trying to get to your wedding. And everybody else and their mother is trying to prevent you from doing that. So you're being attacked by ladies, by spiders, strange people wearing purple hats that lay bombs. These are the main enemy of the game. So, most enemies in this game actually only... So there are two... You see 2 meters there on the screen. A meter that says life, which is obviously your life meter. And another meter below that that says meter, and there's a W and a J. So an H and a J. This is the Jekyll meter, basically. If this drops to zero, you will transform into Mr. Hyde. And the game becomes a completely different game. So as I mentioned in the beginning, this is regarded as being one of the worst games for the NES. I don't think that's actually true, and I don't even think that it's a bad game. I actually think that this game is very well designed. I'm being totally honest here. I do think that this is very well designed, but I think that the reason why people hate this game so much is that it breaks with many video game conventions. And my theory is that the designers of the game deliberately try to make this game, or to be more precise, the part of the game where you play as Dr. Jekyll, to be as annoying as possible. So, for example, there's no real attack that you have when you play as Dr. Jekyll. The only thing that you can do is you can use your walking cane. But the only thing that you can kill with this walking cane are bees. So all other enemies you simply have to avoid. There are these annoying cats. You're being pooped on by birds. These bomb guys are very annoying. And there are even more things later on that are much more annoying. So it's my... So I really think that this is consciously designed to be as annoying as possible. And that's the reason why people don't like this game, because it's simply annoying to play. It's very hard, but it's also not unfair. There is actually a way to dodge things most of the time. I think that this is that this game is hard, but also fair. Okay. So, as I already mentioned, when your hide meter, I mean your jackal meter, drops to zero, you become Dr. You become Mr. Hyde, but that's actually a good thing. Right now, for example, it would be really useful to become Mr. Hyde, because my life meter is quite low, and if your life meter drops to zero, it's just game over. But if you go to the Hyde form and you kill enough enemies, you will go back to the jackal form, but with your life with your life meter refilled. So it's actually a good thing to become Mr. Hyde. Okay. And the second thing that you can do is you can collect these coins. The coin that I just picked up. It only has one purpose, and it's an optional item, but you can use it to pay a lady, basically a lady that sings later on. Yeah, you could say that this part, the hide part, is actually the fun part of the game. Because it's more like a traditional game, and you have an attack. This part is more like really an endurance. That's the right way to think about this. You just have to make it through, and you have to stay calm and collected, despite all the annoying things that that happen here. One of the worst things, the most annoying things, is when you're being attacked at the same time by the bomb guy and another enemy. Of course, the problem is, whenever you're getting hit by someone, you will have a knockback, which will generally draw you towards an exploding bomb. The game also has a progression of difficulty. For example, the bombs will actually explode sooner the further you go into the game. The spiders are another example of why I think this game is purposefully trying to be as annoying as possible, because these spiders have a very unpredictable and possibly random pattern. Yeah, and these bees are also quite annoying. When you're walking up on this walkway, there's actually no reason. So the bombs never, the bomb explosions never actually affect you. So I don't even understand why there are even these bomb laying guys in this section, because The explosion, it can never hit you, and there's actually there's no way to walk below, so you can only walk above, and it's a bit pointless. So as I already mentioned, this game is hard but actually fair. So for every type of enemy, there's basically a strategy that you can adopt, there is a strategy. To avoid every enemy in the game, basically. So these satellites you just want to avoid. What you also want to do is, so this range attack that you have, this psycho wave, what it's called. The thing about this is that once you shoot a projectile, you can only ever have one projectile on the screen at a time. So if I shoot the projectile and I miss, then basically I will be unable to attack until the projectile has returned to me. So the idea is that you try to time your shots such a way that well, first of all, you don't want to miss, and second of all, it's better if you let the enemy come closer to you, because then you will have a higher effective rate of firing. Okay, so this is a difficult situation, because there are a lot of these enemies, and I mean, so let's just call all the enemies that are not the bomb guy enemies of type 2. So if you're being gang raped by those enemies, getting past the bomb guy is very difficult. Okay. Okay. So we're quite low on life, so we have to be careful here. Okay, we are very close to dying. Oh, we just made it. Okay, so, So this, which I think is the third level now. This is, it gets more difficult. Starting from this level. As you can, if I could only kill this boy. I hate this little bastard. Okay. One thing that you want to do is when you're getting hit, by someone, and you're trying to get away from him. Yeah, well, you don't want to do that in any case. Yeah, this is, so we are now dead and the game is over. Fortunately, there is an unlimited number of continues. Yeah, and when we'll come back, folks, we will continue playing Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. So until next time, folks, until then.